Hello, Virgo. We're getting ready to do your reading. The readings are timeless, and we're going to look at your energy, your person's energy, and your outcome. So let's see what we have. Your energy in love is forgiving and learning. As you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moments. Taurus had that also. Your person's energy is pay attention to the red flags. The signs are cautioning you. Let's see what the outcome energy is. Soulmates, look at that. That came out quickly. Yes, this is your soulmate. Okay. So we're going to look at the Lenormand deck and see what the energies are with the Lenormand. I don't know if all of you are familiar with Lenormand, but it's a different deck system than Tarot. Very nice. I really like that it's been around for centuries. All right, lilies, look at that beautiful gift of love. Flowers, the lilies are all about love, purity of love. Okay, let's see what else we have. Ooh, the stars. The stars are coming out tonight. Beautiful energy for you, Virgo. You feel as though this person really is the one. You have a message, a very serious message coming in, Virgo, in love. When we get the letter card, that letter card is about something of significant value to the relationship, information that you need. It's going to have an effect on the course or the destiny of this connection that you have. Let's see what else we have. There we go. The ships, beautiful. So you're really on a journey with this person. It looks as though this is a beautiful journey. Star card is, you know, this is very much the two of you being very, very respectful of each other, very much attracted to each other, very idealistic about one another, willing to, you know, set sail on this beautiful journey together. Some important messages coming in. And what is the final card here for this series? Okay. The Tower card. Now, the Tower card, Lenormand, is actually quite good. It's about stability. It's about structure. It's actually, look at, we have coins and, you know, something beautiful that is being produced by the Tower. Now, for many of you, you know, who don't know the Lenormand deck, I really want you to feel very secure about the meaning of the card. So I'm actually going to, I don't want to guide you incorrectly, so I'm going to read it from the book. The Tower card, a man's mind is want to tell him more than seven watchmen sitting in a tower, Rudyard Kipling. The tower reaching for the sky is a stronghold of imposing authority and bureaucratic power. It may offer protection and structure, such as provided by corporations, governments, and institutions. This card may represent a person or a group with high standards, lofty aspirations. It might denote a social climber, a person reaching for higher status, or a leader who has reached the top of the hierarchy. To me, the meaning of this is it represents the institution of marriage. This card suggests that blindly following or climbing the steps upward can lead to dead ends. But once the summit is reached, you know, you may feel as though it's too limiting, or the Tower card can really also mean that you feel isolated as a couple. So it is a beautiful message, I feel, about you want the stability the Tower is going to give you. It's like the Rock of Gibraltar. It's going to be there for you. But as a couple, it's going to be very important not to isolate yourself from other energies, other people, that it can become its own form of limitation. But when we look at all this gorgeous energy here, the messages, the fact that you're soulmates, I feel as though you're coming into this lifetime to settle many, many previous lifetimes of being split apart. So Let's look and see what your energy is, your person's energy in the outcome cards. Let's see. We're going to clarify everything, and I'm also going to provide an oracle outcome also at the end, so stay tuned. Knight of Swords. So, Virgo, you are all about the truth. You're all about rushing in. Look at this beautiful feather. You know, you're like, you're coming in strong. You're coming in like a burst of wind to speak your truth in this relationship. There's something quite beautiful you have to say to your person, because you might even bring them flowers. I feel as though you're going to tell them how significant they are in your life. I feel as though you're also going to tell them that they represent a very different kind of experience in your love life. You see your person as the Empress. Beautiful. You see your person as divine feminine, feminine energy. There's no, it doesn't matter whether your person is masculine or feminine, but the Empress card is about the abundant growth. She has a baby. She's manifested in her belly. There's room for growth. Your love for this person is aspect of this love really makes you feel as though it can grow abundantly, that this is what you want. This is your wish fulfillment. This is your destiny coming to you. Let's see. We have the Death card. Okay. So you also see the Ten of Pentacles. You also see transformation. So we will clarify this. But your energy coming in is that you want to have experience that's very different from a relationship that ended badly in the past. You want to have a new truth, a new experience. You definitely want to be able to release the past so that you can enjoy the abundance of this relationship. The Ten of Coins is Virgo energy. Here you are in your reading, Virgo. The Death card is Scorpio. The Knight of Swords is Gemini. And the Empress is Taurus. So this beautiful earth sign energy is giving light and life in your heart for something quite divine. Your person and how they feel. This person sees themselves as being very content in the relationship. Virgo, that's your energy once again. We get this beautiful card. Your person feels quite happy. They feel very much that they're content at this moment to watch. They're in a more slow energy. Nine of Pentacles. She's taking her time. She's talking to a bird. She's enjoying life. She's looking for messages. She's looking for red flags. The Six of Wands says that, you know, this energy, this feminine energy of the Nine of Pentacles, again, Virgo energy, that also represents your energy, that your person feels that you're quite reliable, that, you know, you're very attractive. Your person also feels that they're going to have a victory with you. We also see the female emperor energy here, in that your person feels as though they have some say, that they have a voice in how things are going to go in this relationship, that they will sit. This is a female emperor. In this particular deck, there is a male emperor and a female emperor, and your person feels as though the feminine aspect of the emperor energy will be something that they will have in this relationship. When we look at the soulmate energy, both of you are coming from a period of, I believe that you were in separation for a period of time, or that you weren't really talking or interacting. The Four of Cups speaks to the fact that both of you are feeling this energy of the rain having come down over you. But look at this beautiful, I don't know whether it's a goose or a duck, but what we're seeing here is this feeling that both of you have had of discontent, of sadness, of feeling as though there have been rainy days in this relationship. You know, both of you feel like you're enjoying the soulmate energy, but you also both feel as though at some point it became stifling. There was something about your expectations that limited prevented the relationship from growing. And now both of you are seeking to get wind in the sails of the ship to make it come in this direction towards this beautiful energy of love, respect, adoring one another, wanting to give something abundant and special and beautiful and magnificent to one another. No longer do neither of you want a relationship that is any less than what we see on the table for you. The Seven of Cups says that you are both one another's wish on a star. We see the Seven of Cups energy as a fantasy. When you were thinking about each other before you met each other in this lifetime, it really speaks to the fact that you both reached into this energy of, I wish upon a star. The Seven of Cups is a fantasy card, and the Four of Cups and Seven of Cups is the number 11. So again, we have sort of a twin flame sort of feeling here of coming together. There is some sadness here, but again, you have wished to receive one another in this lifetime, and so you have. Let's see, what else is your outcome? The Ace of Swords, beautiful energy. Both of you are coming into this energy as having a very strong clarity, really seeing the key to what is needed to make this relationship a reality, to turn this into something magnificent and beautiful. So holding this key, you have the key of knowledge, the key of, that's also oftentimes a reunion card, the key of really seeing things in a different way that is going to help you move forward. And again, sort of move away from, you like the security of the tower, but moving away from the stagnant feelings back into this very loving energy. Let's see what else is here in your outcome. I am going to clarify the cards for you also. So, you know, stay tuned here. This is a really, this is a new setup that's very detailed. Ten of Wands. All right. So neither of you can endure the burdens of being separated. I feel again as though you've had this separation. You're coming back together in the near future with the ship card. Your ships have arrived in harbor, right? We know that. Okay. What else? Tell us more about the Ten of Wands card, Spirit. Why is the Ten of Wands here? The Eight of Wands. You want to move very quickly and you want to remove the burdens from the relationship. Okay. So let's see what we have now. We're going to clarify how your person feels about you. What does your person feel? Why is the Empress card here? Why is the Empress card here? The Tower card. So you definitely are looking, and your person is looking to have a beautiful manifestation. Both of you are very much looking at relationships from the past. Your person shares this also. They feel as though they had this in their life and then it dissipated, it disappeared. Tower energy, it fell down. That there was at one point in your relationship when it was still quite young, there was some sort of incident, some sort of wounding that happened. I believe, Virgo, that you may have hurt your partner at a very deep level, and it gave a, sent the relationship into some sort of crisis, that whatever this person thought you were going to have or whatever was promised, they feel as though you had a tower moment. The Four of Wands really speaks very clearly to the fact that they need stability from you. Your person really does want this Ten of Pentacles energy. This is Four of Wands. It's the 11-11. That's a bride and groom dancing under the garland. It's a marriage card. Your person really wants to have this legacy marriage. This is about owning a home. If you look at the energy here, we see in the Ten of Pentacles a beautiful, abundant relationship. It's a legacy relationship. It is forever. It's like leaving an inheritance. But what we see is your person is not so focused on the wealth or abundance in the relationship, but the beautiful spiritual stability that you can achieve together. The High Priestess, you're feeling, your person keeps a lot to themselves, Virgo, they, you know, while you're speaking a lot or you're speaking your truth, your person is going to listen very, very carefully to you. High Priestess energy, I feel as though they already know what you're going to say. I feel as though your person is very intuitive. They can feel your energy. They may be rather psychic. The Justice, all beautiful energy. The Justice card is coming in and giving balance to this relationship. The Justice card is a number 20. It's the number 2. So we're looking at, as a couple, the two of you will work very hard to stay balanced. That's Libra energy, so that you can maintain the relationship without having a major ending. It does look, once again, this is a beautiful energy, a beautiful tent, you know, sort of the celebration after a breakup or an incident with the Tower and the Death card. It does look like you were in separation, and that maybe, Virgo, you were the one who initiated the separation. So your person is feeling very much, oh, beautiful, Princess of Discs, Prince of Discs. They feel as though the trust has been reestablished, that they intuitively knew, you know, what the issues were that were concerning you, that both of you together can find your balance. I would also say, for those of you who may be in a situation, I don't see third party here, but it does look like there is a former marriage, the Justice card. It can also indicate the ending of one relationship and the beginning of another one, or the renewal of this relationship after something had to be ended. So when we look at the energy that your person has, or, you know, about the Nine of Pentacles, the Six of Wands, they want a victory. So now let's look, because they want a victory in love. They're going to watch for the red flags. They're looking out for, you know, whatever could go wrong. They're paying close attention to it. Even though it doesn't give that appearance, this person's not worried at all. They're not worried. This is a person who has great confidence, like you, Virgo, in their ability to assess the situation and to solve problems. Again, we get Six of Wands energy, Six of Wands energy. You know, you both want a victory in this relationship. The Ace of Coins, an offer is made. An offer is on the table. When we get the Nine of Pentacles and the Ten of Pentacles, we have the Ten of Pentacles. So your person is very much desirous of a long-term committed relationship with you. The difference is that they're going to move much more slowly than you. The Emperor card is clarifying this winner, winner, chicken dinner. The card of winning, Six of Wands, Six of Wands, Leo energy. Your person is very bent on having success in the relationship with you. Again, this represents the mutual exchange of authority in the relationship. This is beautiful because, again, it's balanced, it's harmonious, it's sharing and communicating, it's avoiding the pitfalls or the red flags. This is the Emperor feminine energy, this is the Emperor masculine energy, and it shows that the two of you can judiciously sort of rule over the relationship with great success, that you will make a great partnership, and that is a huge focus of your partner's energy. You're not focused in the same way. You want to make sure that there's equal give and take. You want to make sure that, you know, you don't have to deal with someone who's going to be, you know, the Tower card can mean anger, a big fight. You know, it looks as though that's something that, Virgo, you've experienced in the past, and you're really just going out of your way to reinvent how you're coming into this relationship. This person is very much on the same page with you about all that energy. It's very important to them, but they're also seeing equal give and take, sort of co-rulership of the kingdom, quote unquote, of the relationship. Your person wants equality. It's very important. And you have an understanding that that's what's needed also. A little bit different way of looking at things, but it's okay. It takes two. The Nine of Cups, oh, great happiness after feeling left out in the cold. Great happiness, a time of celebration that is an outcome clarifier for you. It does look as though the number nine is coming into play. Again, 9-9, you know, is 18. 1 and 8 is 9, so it is fulfillment of, you know, a certain level of destiny in this relationship. Why do we have the Ace of Swords? You have great clarity. The Nine of Swords. Okay, so after a period of time of feeling as though there was a great misunderstanding here, I think. I feel as though there was, the relationship was moving a little too quickly at the beginning. I feel as though it faltered, that there was a period of time in which you had to reinvent the relationship, that there was a breakup, and I feel very clearly a makeup, okay? Because we see the journey of all of that. We see the journey that's going on. But let's see what we have. So the Nine of Swords is clarifying the Ace of Swords. The thing that had you both all up in your head, very fussing, feeling very closed off, feeling very alone, feeling just so sad, your communication is coming in. It's beautiful. You're sharing your love for one another. You're sharing your emotions, and it gives you both clarity about the reality that both of you wished upon a star, this beautiful soulmate energy. And you have the Four of Pentacles. Both of you are holding on to each other. You're both holding back. You're not really overdoing it because you don't want to overwhelm the energy in the relationship. You don't want to get into an exhaustion level again. You are speeding up, though. The energy of the Eight of Wands is taking flight, going on a vacation, making love, feeling the wonderful energy that came flying out, and it was upright on the way out. The Lover's card. So the Lover's energy is coming in. There is this beautiful soulmate reconnection for the two of you, and you will continue to explore the relationship and actually redefine it. Redefine it from being structurally sound and limiting into something much more spiritual, equally being there in the relationship together, guiding the ship, looking for red flags, sort of really, you have each other's back. So that is your reading. Sending you love from Chicago. Send some back. Tell me where you're from. Take care, Virgo.